What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Married to Film. I'm Ralph, and this is Shimonda.
Hola.
Right now, we're at episode 2 of Daryl Dixon. First episode showed us how he got to France. Showed us that he escaped from some people. And he was on a little, I don't even know what you would have called it. It wasn't a raft, a boat, or nothing. It was just
like a door.
Right. Floating in the water.
Yeah.
But he's come across, I think, Isabel, and they're going north, I believe. With, can't think of the kid's name.
Sorry, who is she? It's the second episode?
Mm-hmm. Is that Isabel?
Is that the nun?
Right.
Or maybe it's a flashback. Oh, Lord.
Get
it. Wow. Y'all in a whole nother world. Oh, and watches. Girl, don't put. What the? What is this? A downer?
Sober right on up, didn't she?
Well, she took a downer, I'm sure. That cigarette probably was her jersey. No, girl. Girl, his face is like... Run! Girl, run! Oh, girl, up, up this, up.
I've seen somebody hit a walker in the mouth.
Okay, listen. Look.
Lily?
If you hear growling, you better run.
Lily?
Wow, okay.
Lily?
Wow. Putain, doucement, il est super tôt, là. Je sais pas, il passe un truc horrible, mais
il est là. Isabel.
Bébé?
Oh, this baby gonna get bit.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a person you knew?
Oui.
Then it must be a dead person.
That is not a question.
I don't need a question. Everyone you know is dead, except us.
Monsieur Darien,
what kind of death would you prefer?
How about a quiet one?
Hey! Don't mess with the animals, they said something.
Right. Oh, man.
How do you get him to shut up?
Asterix is very stubborn.
It's okay. He's passing on them. He'll make it. Let's go. Grab everything. Let's move. Just tell him the truth.
Okay.
It's gotta learn sometime.
You don't have children, do you?
Yeah, I got plenty.
Right.
Shh.
The Negan clan. Kill him, you got your weapon.
How are we gas masking out here? In the woods with poison ivy. It's a trap, don't go down the stairs.
Right.
Oh! I said it's a trap.
Did they hit me when I said it?
The Wiz kids? It's freaking the kids off of Peter Pan. What they called?
Boys.
The Lost Boys.
What's that say?
It was a preschool.
Wow.
On est des gens d'église. On a perdu notre mule, on s'est retrouvés coincés.
Donc vous saurez me réciter la prière pour les parents de Saint-Joseph?
Et lui? Père David. Il vient d'Amérique. Il a été envoyé en mission à l'époque. Il parle pas français.
Depuis tout ce temps?
C'est américain.
Yeah!
Now we will talk back to English. Out of respect for Father Daryl. Okay, on y va? Let's go.
And the younger ones?
Orphans? Are we friends of the years? Karim was left here in the basket.
Oh!
There are a lot of kids.
Lost in the woods.
So how do you survive?
We hunt.
You should know all this by yourselves. This is Madame Dubois.
She's our parents. And our nurse. Teaches everything. And she got sick.
Oh, Lord, you're about to break. Father Daryl.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good. And he's our
chef. Hopefully you learn from Gabriel.
Hi, I'm Laurel.
You can't sit there. That chair is for my brother.
Les enfants, prenez-moi. Father Daryl, would you lead us in a prayer of thanks?
You called it.
He already eaten.
Right.
You mean like saying grace?
Yes.
Yeah.
He better not cuss. Thank you for keeping us safe and safe and bang.
Lord, I'm sure you have your reasons for turning the whole world upside down.
Ooh.
Maybe we deserve it. For being so mean to each other. We probably do deserve it. But not tonight.
Mm.
No. Tonight is good. Mm. And if this isn't good enough for you, I don't know what is. Mm. Amen.
He said, no
that,
way.
That, yeah.
Look, they don't know the program.
Mm-hmm.
But Daryl's like, no way.
Right.
Look, he's smiling.
That would be me. That would be me.
Daryl don't smile often.
Mm-hmm.
Only with Judith and Carol.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and,
I can't think of her name right now. Kelly's sister.
Want to know what the world was like before?
You can't mess with what you never had.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
We have to stop for a minute.
Her sister. She must be affected. She said she wasn't feeling good.
Yep.
Dang it!
He gonna put her down, too.
If you need a doctor, Lily, we can take you. You just have to decide if you're sick or not. Oh.
She's sick.
She's pregnant.
What's going on?
She's with child.
She's the AMGs.
Find us somewhere safe.
I know that's right.
Okay.
I ain't leaving myself.
Can you go grab us some snacks?
Alright, I'll find us somewhere. Alright.
You could have at least filled up the car while you was there at the gas station.
Priest.
Is that obvious?
Yes. Hey, how did you come to France?
It's a long story. The only part that matters is I get home to my people.
She'll get better, thanks to you.
Je suis bien mal.
Something hurts.
Okay.
Girl, no, it wasn't.
Walkers.
Especially if she's good. No, keep going.
Don't cut it off.
I don't think it's cut off. The windshield wipers are still going.
What's the matter with you?
Get back in the car!
Why y'all scared?
Why y'all just looking there? They just got scratched. It's a castle for real. Oh, Uncle Daryl don't play. Don't be killing no kids. Oh! Hello! Yeah.
C'est une ferme tout à l'heure.
Woo! Girl.
C'est qui le père?
Oh. Oh. Oh, dang.
Promets-moi, tu t'occuperas de mon bébé. Même ma fille, qu'est-ce que tu auras promis? Promets que tu t'occuperas de mon bébé.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
You'll be safer in there. Besides, I'm better off on my own.
Come on!
Don't make no ruckus, girl. Shut your mouth. Oh, it's food in there too. Y'all can live there.
Mm-hmm. A lot of medication.
Oh, excuse me, syringes and everything. Excuse me.
Let me out. Whoa, ça va? Ça va, j'ai rien fait?
Shut up. I don't speak French.
English?
Yeah. I speak English too. Please, don't shoot. Back to school. Come on.
Well, dang.
Mm. What you shooting at now?
Does this look familiar?
Yeah, Last of Us.
Yep.
Got it. You're American. Me too. God damn, a fellow American. Name's RJ. RJ Gaines. Heidi Giddings.
That's all that matters, brother. I ain't your fucking brother. East Coast, Midwest, even Texas.
Gone.
Everybody you know back home is gone.
Oh, no.
You don't know your ass from your elbow.
He tries anything, you shoot him.
Oh, my boy.
Yeah.
Right over it. Feed him to the boy. Feed him to the man. You said I'm an American. They don't speak English. Woo!
This is crazy.
She went back and got the kids. Maybe they went back and got the kids. Maybe they went back and got the kids.
Oh, God. Do it now.
There you go.
All right.
I told you she went and got the lost boys.
Yeah.
Y'all gonna pull him up? Turn around there and get the left. Oh, okay. Oh, praise the Lord, they got a horse. I forgot. Cause I'm like, this little kid can't pull him up. He's gonna be getting. He's gonna see his brother.
Oh my God, don't jump down there.
Yep, he's gonna see his brother. Yep. Daryl.
Daryl's weapon right there.
It's too late.
My meds were never gonna help her. I lied to you to get a horse. I'm sorry.
Fine time to tell her, you know what I'm saying?
What am I gonna do without her?
My teacher is also with the angels. Nanu.
I knew that was gonna come up somehow. I did. I just knew it. But I thought Daryl was gonna be the one to do it. But that's cool. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Some good food right there.
Oh, the nuns. I think they took them up.
Oh, I guess Daryl's recording.
My name's Daryl Dixon.
She's gonna turn and bite him. Crap.
Me so special anyway. I want to be like other kids.
Is there an angel or a process on Lorraine? How does she name him? We about to find out.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Alright, so that was Alouette. I like that one. That was really good. We got Isabelle's backstory. She was wilding out when the zombie apocalypse happened.
She was in a rave. What's it called? Rage?
Rave.
Rave. Sorry. She was at a rave. I said rage.
Wilding out. Drinking, doing cocaine, everything.
She was doing it all.
Yeah.
Uppers, downers.
Yeah. No, she came across zombies as it was coming through. She went home to get her sister.
As it was coming through.
Yeah. Get her sister so they could get out of there. How did she meet the guy? I can't remember.
She didn't meet him. He came and got her.
Okay. Yeah, but her sister was pregnant and sick.
7 months.
7 months. Wow. Yep.
I mean, she would be sick if she ain't never went to a doctor, mm-hmm. and she's now 7 months, so she was coming upon some complications. She went into labor, basically.
Mm-hmm.
She said she hadn't been feeling good, but, you know.
Yeah, and the guy that picked her up wanted to drop the sister off at a clinic somewhere and leave her. And Isabelle wasn't having that, so she took his keys and they left. And then they,
She was a pickpocket.
Yeah.
Pickpocket.
Yeah.
Her.
They came across the ambulance, and that's how her sister got bit. But then they wound up at the convent, and
her sister got bit because they didn't want to. They were just standing there.
She got out the car first of all, and yeah, and they took forever to get back in the car.
They just watching them walk toward them. Oh, let me run now while they're already on my.
Oh my God! Yeah.
On the heel of my foot.
So they get to the convent and. They deliver the baby, she dies during childbirth. Isabelle's taking care of Laurent. And she got the name from a saint that was had a statue in the convent. So that was that. Daryl and Isabelle, on their way north, came across the Lost Boys. And they helped them. Yeah. Exactly. You know what? Daryl loved the kids. You know, he always has. So. What was great is they was in there watching Mork and Mindy, and they knew all the lines. That was sweet.
Every last one of them.
Right, that was sweet.
Kids were doing everything by themselves. Mm-hmm. They had a good place, protection. They had actual doors with weaponry, swords sticking out of them. So, but that was a good fence, basically. They were growing their own food, taking care of the nurse that was in there. She had been sick for the last 6 months, so they didn't have no adults.
Mm-hmm.
The oldest girl, she looked like she was no more than maybe 17.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly what age I was thinking about.
And it looked like she was the oldest out of all of them, and she was the leader. Probably didn't want to be in that position, but she mm-hmm. is. I mean, they had little babies in there. And, there was a lot of conversations as, like, Laurent not able to relate to the other kids because he's been with adults his whole life. Mm-hmm. And the kids he couldn't really relate to. But they had their own, you know, their own family, basically. They were all together and stuff. So it was a really good episode.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, from the dialogue between Isabelle and Daryl. While they were, okay, so they were in the bed together, but not in the bed together.
Mm-hmm.
How she was asking him, look, so you're going to go do this tomorrow? And he was like, yeah, I need that horse. He was like, that medicine ain't going to help that lady. Mm-hmm. She's going to die anyway. So she was like, so you lied to him? He was like, oh, dang, I meant to write it down.
Connie.
Connie, thank you. I said starting with a C. Thank you. 45 minutes later.
Out the blue.
The reason why we're laughing is because Daryl was smiling when he was watching Mork and Mindy with the kids, and I was like, there's only two times that he's ever smiled, and that's with Carol and Judith. Mm-hmm. And then I said, no, and we was trying to think of her name, and he said, Connie's.
I said, Kelly's sister.
Yeah, Kelly's sister. 45 minutes later. Right. But anyway, so their conversation was basically like, the truth, we'll tell them the truth later. And he did. He told him the truth. At the wrong time.
It was so blunt,
man. When they were burying the nurse. Isn't that when he told him?
Yeah.
And they was like, when they buried the nurse, they was like, they tugged on the ear and nanu nanu. Mm-hmm. Just like Mork and Mindy. But he told him the truth. Did you hear my stomach just now? Mm-hmm. That's weird. Told him everything. I don't know. I actually love this episode. Mm-hmm. Laurent came across the mule because they had to let the mule go because the mule stopped and sensed that there was walkers there, but didn't want to go any further. And they was like, he's just stubborn. It's okay. So Daryl let him go and he ran through him, but he eventually got caught by the walkers, mm-hmm. and was eaten and everything. And he was upset about that. There was one little boy that didn't want Laurent to sit beside him because he was leaving that chair for his brother. Mm-hmm. When he came back to rescue Daryl, he looked over the bridge and he seen his brother as a walker. And he was like, you lied to me, to the older girl. It was a lot of stuff going on, and mm-hmm. I really like it. It reminded me of the Oceanside kids, too, because mm-hmm. it was a lot of kids on that side.
Yeah.
And then just the simple fact that it was like Alexandria, mm-hmm. too, with the growing their own food and stuff, mm-hmm. like that. How they actually was able to do that. I mean, because this is all they know.
Mm-hmm.
So, kudos to the kids, the mm-hmm. Lost Boys and the girls.
And we know that Isabelle and Daryl is going to be chased by the one guy that they didn't kill at the convent because he found Daryl's recording and he looked at the map and knows where they're going. So, he's going to be on their heels. So.
By himself.
Yeah. He's probably going to meet up with some people.
I mean, yeah, of course. He's going to come back for, he got a radio or something. He's going to
come back blasting.
Yeah. Well, Daryl will be ready.
Yep.
Listen.
All right. So let us know what you guys thought of that video. We'll see y'all next time.
Love you guys. Love y'all. Shout out to Earth Dog for our beautiful thumbnails.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, wake up.